Times are changing, and Indians are today increasingly looking to enhance the quality of their lives, which in turn enhances their self-confidence. The healthcare industry is actively supporting this transformation by offering latest technologies to ease the process and effectively cater to this rising demand. In our series, Enriching Lives, we will today dwell upon one such technology that is being commonly used and its impact on creating a positive change, which is laser hair removal.
Increasing disposable income, higher consciousness on personal grooming, and greater awareness about the safety offered by laser devices are some of the key propellers for the growth of the laser market in India.
In the last decade, we have noticed there is an increasing demand of laser hair removal, not just in women, but in men too these days. And there is a social influence. There's so much of, the Instagram and Facebook, and there's so much of advertising about laser hair removal. And we are seeing more and more clients, you know, asking for this procedure.
Today was the laser thing I got done, and it was my first experience for upper lips. I thought it would be painful, but it wasn't. Because waxing and the threading thing is actually a little painful, and you have to keep doing it. I mean, in a week, it'll grow back again, you'll have to run to the parlor. I think this is much better.
To discuss the demand and supply of laser hair removal technology in India, the challenges still being faced and its future prospects, I have an eminent panel here with me today. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
We have Dr. Ganesh Pai, Medical Director at Dermacare Skin and Cosmetology Center in Mangalore. Dr. Simal Soin, a respected name in the field of aesthetics and cosmetic dermatology, and also the medical director at Aina Clinic. We have Dr. Rajita Damisetti, a dermatologist and medical director at Oliver Chain of Clinics. Mrigakshi Parashar, a theatre actor who's been performing in plays across the country. Laser hair removal is considered to be one of the most common procedures around the world as we know it. So to understand the demand for it in India better, could you give us an idea on what are the numbers? Have they been increasing over the last 5 years? Dr. Simal, can we start with you?
Just to give you a sense that we are at a time in medical aesthetics today in the history when laser hair removal is, and it's actually laser hair reduction, if I might say, is possibly the most popular procedure worldwide. And of course, that's because there's great technology, right, easily available. But what's happening now is that there's lots of women coming in like they've always done. There's more and more women coming in. Mm-hmm. But the most striking and amazing feature is we've got a lot of men coming in as well for laser hair reduction. And you'd wonder why. Because they come in for areas like the chest hair, for torsos, for beard shaping. And so it's not just about hair reduction happening or totally going away, but just to get softer, easily manageable hair.
We are here basically addressing people on two lines. One is the racial, mm-hmm. Which is genetic, and which is what Dr. Simal talked about. Excessive body hair, which people want to get rid of for comfort reasons, hygiene reasons.
Correct.
And hormone issues, hormonal problems, which lead to growth in the mustache, chin and beard area in women, and which causes a lot of social embarrassment. And so there are two different issues. In fact, both are increasing in terms of demand.
Doctor, I see most common people would use the word laser hair removal, but today I'm noticing the medical practitioners are saying medical hair reduction. Is there any reason?
Yes, the reason is that whereas the machine does hair removal, mm-hmm. effectively what you're doing is hair reduction, because you can never get rid of 100% of the hairs.
Okay.
So the terminology today is permanent hair reduction. Let's say somebody started with 1,000 hairs, we can probably get it down to about 200. The very fine hairs eventually would not go,
right,
because the energy levels which are required to blast those can damage the skin. So about 80% of the hairs eventually, you agree with me?
Yes, both.
About 80% completely would go, and the rest would become so thin
that
they would become vestigial, like on the arms of a 4-year-old or a 5-year-old. Yeah.
Right.
And so then the laser doesn't achieve its purpose. So for patients, it's fine to say, doctor, I want hair removal. For us, it's fine to say you're going to undergo permanent hair reduction.
Can you talk us through the entire procedure? What are the precautions that one needs to take? How many sittings? And what is the aftercare needed?
Now, the number of sessions that one needs will depend on the skin type, the hair type, and the body part. So you could divide this into someone with, who has a natural body hair, or a woman who has some kind of a hormonal problem, most commonly polycystic ovarian syndrome, PCOS, and she has hair in a male pattern. So if it is the normal natural hair like everybody does on the arms, the legs, the underarms, the bikini area, then usually around 6 to 8 sessions would do. And if it is someone who's rather dark skinned or has rather finer hair, it would need a few more sessions. And the interesting thing here is that the thicker the hair, the easier it is to reduce it using lasers. And post-care would be very simple. At the most, an antibiotic cream would be applied, and people would be forbidden from doing things like a steam or a swim immediately afterwards, and that's about it.
Mrigakshi, I'd like to ask you, you're from an industry where it's always important to look good or look perfect, if I may say so. Is excessive hair growth a cause for concern?
Yeah, you could say that to an extent. In my industry, I have come across a lot of people, both men and women. They are very conscious when it comes to the shooting time. Right. When there's a shoot, they're really conscious about where they're standing, which angle they're standing at, and how close the camera is to you. So in that sense, I think there is a lot of concern that they put on this issue. Mm-hmm. And I think this in this process, their level of self-confidence also gets affected. So yeah, you could say that when it comes to this industry, some people are really concerned about hair growth in the, specifically in those areas which is visible to the audience.
Right. Yeah. With healthcare brands flooding the market with latest technologies to cater to the growing demand for hair reduction, Alma, a global innovator of laser-based solutions for the aesthetic and surgical markets, has been revolutionizing existing treatment methods to add to product efficiency. Soprano Titanium, a hair reduction system from Alma, is being successfully used in the healthcare market due to the additional and effective features it offers.
Soprano Titanium is a breakthrough hair removal platform that combines functionality with unparalleled comfort. Its large 4 cm square spot size and advanced cooling system give a much faster and pain-free treatment. Soprano Titanium also leverages the benefits of 3 combined wavelengths with an improved patient experience.
So, Doctor, what's your experience using Soprano Titanium for laser hair reduction? The triple wavelength method, is it? How does it change the hair growth pattern?
Well, if you look at the advent of the hair removal laser devices, we started with single wavelengths. We had the 755.
Okay.
The 810 and the 1064. And each of them were doing a separate jobs, good at certain colors of the skin.
Okay.
For instance, the 1064 would be better in dark skins. Now, and the 75 would be in very light skins. And the 810 would be for almost everything. But now we have a combination of all 3 energies in one handpiece, so you get the best of all 3. So effectively, what happens is that we're using lesser power than we would use with a single handpiece. So the chances of burning the skin come down. It's much cooler to do it because the patients feel it more acceptable, less pain. And also the handpiece has a very cold hand tip in it, about 4 degrees centigrade. So you feel that the patient has some sort of a very pleasant experience. So that's a big plus. And also the speed is tremendous. With this particular machine, you can get up to 40% more speed, which means people can get in and get out of the clinic much faster, especially if they're doing a whole body hair removal. And also we can do more numbers in a single day.
So when people come to you for a treatment, let's say for laser hair reduction, what do they want? They want a quick treatment.
Right.
They want a safe treatment. Yeah. They want an effective treatment. They want a painless treatment.
Yes.
And they want a well-priced treatment.
Right.
And in my view, the way that Soprano Titanium now works, we've got all of these together.
So yes, there are many products in the market, and as a medical practitioner, how do you choose? Where does Soprano Titanium come into the picture? What is the checklist?
It's a tried and trusted brand. You know, it's
right.
Over the years, over the couple of decades, we've seen this company evolve, and I think this is the 5th generation of hair removal device that they're making. Oh. So that's one big plus for us. We're familiar with the technology. And in fact, it was this, Alma introduced this technology about 15 years ago when they had this high repetition rate, low frequency, low energy levels. So most of the lasers earlier were like slingshots, very painful, and all the energy was delivered in one go on the skin. So not only it would burn the hair root, it would also, chances are, burn the skin. Alma brought this to bringing in repetitive shots, giving the same quantum amount of energy over a period of time, which would have been achieved with a single shot. But that eliminated the pain factor and the burn factor, and also led to an equivalent amount of hair loss, making it a very safe procedure.
Mrigakshi, this has been called as a lunch break process, which means it's not just fast, but it's also super easy to get back to work, and it's comfortable. It's not very painful. Do you think this is an important factor in the increasing number of people actually turning to this treatment?
Yeah, of course, it could be one of the very important factors. Everybody is in a rush nowadays.
Yeah.
Even for some of my friends, even 24 hours falls short.
Yeah.
So I remember you'd find me rushing to a parlor every time there's a shoot coming up.
Right.
And so I really would look for something that is time efficient.
Mm-hmm.
And in that process of doing so, I mostly quite like end up spending a lot of money. So a lot of my friends who have who are looking for such alternatives to regular waxing and, you know, other grooming processes, they suggest that, you know, it's laser treatment would be a very viable alternative because it is time efficient and also efficient in saving money.
Right.
So yeah.
So would you say that laser hair reduction process is for anyone and everyone?
Yes, pretty much everyone, but from 16 years of age up until when their hair is all black.
Right.
Because, you know, it doesn't work on grey hair. But apart from that, the only conditions which we do not like to do it in is when people are pregnant or lactating or they're nursing. Essentially, because not that anything's going to happen to the baby, but because the hormones are so fluctuating, you could never be sure of the results in any case. That's the main reason why we don't. And the other medical conditions where there are certain medical conditions where you would possibly exercise caution, like conditions like leukoderma or psoriasis for the skin or epilepsy where light stimulation can cause a reaction, or that's really it. But usually, by and large, Dr. Pai will also, I'm sure, add to that.
And we have medical conditions where we need to do it. For instance, people coming with folliculitis of the hair. Hair follicle infections, which is a very sorry state of affairs because they get pus all over their legs and they need to have those hair removed. Then there's a condition called hidradenitis suppurativa, which are, you know, inflamed glands in the underarms. And then you have people who have keloids. Keloids, the problem with keloids is the hairs around, these are most often seen in the chest. And when these keloids come up, the hairs turn on them and prick them, irritating and making them grow faster. So it's nice to have hair removal done around the keloid so that it does not irritate the keloid anymore.
I'd like to know your opinion on has laser hair reduction still got a stigma attached to it? Because we're seeing numbers increasing. I think you all have experienced through the clinics, there are more people coming in for it, but we still don't really talk about it.
So I have to say, not laser. Aesthetics generally has been associated with stigma because I think we as a people want to look good, but we want to say, no, we did it all naturally. Indians are generally natural about it. But I think laser hair reduction less than others because people, if anybody refers somebody, it's usually only for laser hair reduction. And I was with somebody the other day, a gentleman who's come in for laser hair reduction, and he was talking about it in front of his daughters and said how much happier he is and how it's made his life so comfortable. So there's not that much stigma around it, generally. People talk about having laser hair reduction.
Correct. Well, most men and women commonly face this very, very real problem of unwanted hair growth. But here's a solution. Now we're going to take a short break and come back to lay threadbare this topic by helping you select the best center for this procedure and also busting the myths surrounding laser hair removal. Wow. Welcome back to our special series, Enriching Lives, where we're talking about laser technologies that are supporting the rising demand of people to enhance the quality of their lives. Continuing with the discussion where we left it off, Dr. Rajita, I wanted to understand from you, how does laser hair reduction help women that actually have excessive hair growth due to hormonal reasons?
So the laser would take care of the hair that is present at that moment in three ways. Some of the hairs would be dead completely and you can't really wake up the dead. So that's gone forever. And some of them would become rather fine. Right. And as we keep doing more and more sessions, they would become so fine that they no longer bother the person. And then there's a third category where the hair is kind of put to sleep. It goes into a hibernating mode. Okay. And if we do not correct the hormonal imbalance simultaneously, then what happens is that the sleeping hairs are woken up. And whatever is becoming thinner because of the effect of the laser is going to become thickened by the hormones. So this is not something that you do as a standalone procedure. Laser hair reduction in these women who have a excess of male hormone, testosterone, most commonly because of PCOS or because of various other reasons, they need to control their male hormone excess. Also, they need to control their insulin excess while they're going through the laser hair reduction procedure. Otherwise, we will not get optimal results.
How critical is it to find the right treatment, the right center, the right doctor? For example, if I were to go in for this treatment, what should be the points that I need to look out for?
I will answer that. That's very important. You see, I always tell people who come to my clinic, for them, a laser is a laser. Yes. There are lasers costing 5 lakhs and there are lasers costing 50 lakhs. Those are the best machines. The expensive machines have add-on features which prevent burns, which give better balanced energy and more effective hair reduction vis-a-vis the cheaper ones. And therefore, the more expensive machines are found in better centers like we have.
Right.
And therefore, that makes it much safer for the patients to undergo the procedure. So I would tell the public, before you step into a center for hair removal, find out the brand of the machine they are using. Then Google it up and see which are those in that category. Make sure the machine that is going to be playing on your hair roots, on your skin, is a good machine which doesn't burn your skin.
Right.
Because if it burns your skin, it's going to be permanent and that destruction is going to lead to a lot of unhappiness.
What are the procedural challenges in laser hair reduction treatment?
I think it's about the number of sessions that people think about. Ah. So I think that people need to understand that laser has an end point. Because sometimes you will see people who've come in from centers where they've had 30 sessions of laser hair reduction. Yeah. I think it's important that people understand that, they have a certain number of sessions, 6 to 8, have a good result, and then if they need maintenance, they have that. Then also they've got to understand the gaps between laser sessions. For example, it's not one session, and why? Because you're targeting the follicle in the growth phase. It's a particular part of the hair cycle in the phase of the follicle, which is targeted. And all hair follicles are in different phases at different times. So that's why you need multiple sessions.
And there's another catch to this. If you find, and this is what I tell a lot of young women who come today, that you came with a moderate quantity of hair, which went down with the good machine, but after 6 to 8 months or a year, the hair started thickening again, go and check for polycystic ovary disease. See, when they come to us, we do a hormone profile. Right. There is no polycystic ovary disease to see. But a year or two later, they are manifesting polycystic ovary disease. They think your machine is not working well. They think you don't know how to do a hair removal laser. But actually, they're having developing polycystic ovary disease. So I ask them, if the hairs are coming back after about 6 months to a year, go and get a hormone check done again and then come back. So you don't have to blame the doctor or the machine.
Well, yes, it is in fact these unfound myths that have often prevented people from actually going in for laser treatment. We want to know more about these myths from you and your personal experiences with your patients.
So there's this very weird, unfounded belief that lasers can cause cancer. And it is extremely unfounded. There's no logic to it.
Okay.
Now, laser is basically a powerful light that doesn't go beyond the skin. And in fact, lasers are used to treat cancers rather than cause cancers.
Like we've talked about, intelligent people will realize the inconvenience of having waxing done every 15, 20 days. And of course, a cost that's going to be incurred over a lifetime, over a one-time cost for really laser, where it becomes so much easier for everybody.
The price is just probably the number that scares them. But if you actually do the math.
If you do the math, yes.
Mrigakshi, what about you, your friends? Has anyone actually tried laser hair reduction and really seen their lives change? Any experience?
Yeah, a few of my friends have undergone this treatment. They feel prepared all the time. They are prepared for every shoot. Instead of rushing with us to the parlors, they are doing their own relaxing jobs. Yeah,
it's liberating, is it? You plan to follow their footsteps.
We'll see.
And also, Indians were always covered traditionally before with saris, and now they wear shorter clothes. The new generation, you know, go to the beach, and so it's
as actors and anchors, you just don't know when your next shoot is. Sometimes, so I think I can completely understand.
So the
that.
Old adage was. Babies' heads have no hair.
Mm-hmm.
Old men's heads are just as bare. Between the cradle and the grave lies a haircut and a shave. And now I'll add, and a laser.
And a laser. All right, that's lovely. To wrap up our discussion, I'd like to ask each and every one of you for your opinion on what is the future of laser hair reduction technology, more so in India?
Like with titanium, we are really... I think at its laser hair reduction at its best, mm-hmm. it can only get better, can't it? I mean, we have to ask the company. They've come, this is the fifth generation of great hair reduction. Let's see, maybe this robotic or something happening.
In the meantime, we're looking at faster technologies. We're looking at safer technologies, particularly for darker skin. Mm-hmm. And we're looking at this technology breaking through the metro barrier to second, third tier cities, towns. And we're looking at... having a democratization of laser availability. And I think that's the way India is going.
Fabulous. We hope today's discussion would have helped you in making up your mind to register for your hair removal, hair reduction session, which you'd probably been postponing or avoiding for months. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you all for being here.